Hi, everyone. My name is Pastor Jeremy, and I'm representing Faith Fellowship right now. And this is Pastor Ariel. Who are you with?
I am with New Life Church out of Port Townsend, Washington.
That's right. It's exciting. We're actually coming together to do something awesome, to do something big. And so we have one really big idea, one really crazy and awesome and fun idea, and then also one really big ask of you. So first off, let's talk about the idea. Now, normally every summer, we would have some sort of a summer experience, like a summer camp, summer road trips, things like that. All across our state, everywhere that you go, they are closed up.
Yes.
They aren't having summer camps.
Nope.
And that to me is just, well, that's, for lack of a better word, that sucks.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That sucks. You know, for me personally, I actually was saved at a summer camp. That was where I first found out about Jesus. That was where I first learned Jesus and where I was able to connect that. And so summer camps to me are really big and important. And it's something that also, it changes your whole perspective, where kids and students are able to come together with leaders. They're able to get into the Word. They're able to learn more about Jesus. And they have an experience that they're going to remember for the rest of their lives. And you know what? We came together and we said, we're not okay with not having camp. So we aren't okay with not having summer camp.
Mm-mm.
Like we need to do something together.
Mm-hmm.
We need to do something that's gonna be big and fun and amazing and something that the students are gonna remember, but we also need to do it safely and we need to make sure that we are being absolutely responsible. And so here's the big idea.
What is the big idea?
The big idea is this. We are having summer camp.
What?
Yeah, it's crazy, I know. But we're gonna have summer camp and it's gonna be amazing and it's gonna be incredible and students are gonna love it. It's gonna be so much fun. We're gonna do it in the most responsible way possible.
We are?
We're gonna do it in a way that is gonna be safe and fun and it's gonna be awesome. But here's how we're gonna do it. On the middle part of July, so in the middle week of July, we're gonna be going down to Idaho.
Idaho?
Idaho, that's right.
Wait, Not in Washington.
Not in Washington.
Idaho.
Idaho is where the potatoes grow.
Okay.
That's right. In Idaho. So it's going to be really close to Coeur d'Alene and really close to Silverwood.
Okay.
But we are going to be staying at a resort called Silver Mountain Resort.
Ooh.
It's an amazing resort that's just filled with so much fun. They have an indoor water park. This indoor water park has indoor surfing.
Yes.
We've got water slides.
Yes.
We have a big area on the side. It's going to be this grassy field, which is going to be amazing. We can set up and have youth gatherings there every single night. They have hikes and things that we're going to be doing in the mornings for youth Bible studies. Hikes. It's going to be super fun. They also have a gondola, not the oh sol mio kind of gondola, but no, the hanging gondola that goes up the mountains, right? It's going to be awesome. And it happens to be the biggest, longest gondola ride in the United States.
Come on.
Yeah, it's going to be amazing. It takes 55 minutes to get up to the top. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be so much fun. We're going to be doing that. We're also going to have one day, because Silverwood Theme Park is right there, we're also going to have one day over at Silverwood Theme Park. Every night, the students are going to hear messages from different pastors, and they're going to hear, and they're going to come together, and we're going to have youth gatherings. Every morning, they're going to be studying the Bible, and every day, we are going to be having so much fun and having experiences together, right in a time where students need to be together the most. So right now, though, here's the thing is students have been cooped up. They have been stuck inside. They're not able to do much. And again, I want to be very clear. We're going to do this in the most responsible and best way possible. We're going to do this following all laws and guidelines and everything. But we're also going to find a way, and we have found a way, to get the students out in the middle of July and say, let's do camp together. Let's be together. Let's actually come together in this amazing, fun, and just extreme, incredible way. It's going to be so much fun. But here's the big ask. Here's the big ask. Now, in order to do this right, and to make sure that we have the best experience possible for all of these students, to have the best experience possible for the students, for the leaders, for everybody to be able to just have this week, this amazing week that they're going to remember for the rest of their lives, I'm going to guarantee you this, there's going to be changed lives. There's going to be changed lives from this, and it's incredible. It's going to be so much fun. It's going to be changed lives. There's going to be people that are knowing Jesus who never knew Jesus before. There are going to be people saying yes to Jesus. It's going to be an incredible time. We cannot wait, but we have to do this as responsible as possible. And the way that we have to do this, also in going down to the resort, it costs money. right? It does. It costs money. It
no
costs
small
money.
Potatoes.
No small potatoes. It costs money. And so here is my big ask for you. My big ask for you and for all of the churches that are going to be participating in this and coming together and so forth is it does cost money. And in order for us to make this as cheap as possible for the students, because we want to make sure that in this time that the students aren't having to pay, you know, $900 a person, right? We want to make sure that the cost is lower. The cost is low so that way they're able to come. We can get as many students as we possibly can, as many leaders and so forth. In order to do that though, we need $8,000.
What?
We need $8,000 donated. $8,000. I think we can do that between all of us together. If we were to all just, you know, put in a little bit of something, $8,000 to be able to do this would lower the cost for every student and every leader. It would make it so most leaders are going to be very low at about $50 for them to be able to come and participate and actually be able to lead. It makes it for every student would only be charged to about $120 to $140 per family. Now, when you look at that in the whole general scheme of things, most summer camps, most places like this are usually about $350, right? $350 for them to go out and have this time. We're trying to make it under that because right now we're saying, you know what? Students need out and they need something incredible to look forward to. Right now, all the students are just, they're at home, they're alone, they're stuck, and it's lonely and it's hard and their fellowship has been weighed down. It is difficult for that. We've been trying to do the best we can with Zoom meetups and stuff like that, and we're trying to get people connected, but it's not the same. But in July, in the middle of July, that is the time where we're able to actually come together. That is the time where we're gonna be able to, with guidelines and legally, be able to do this and say, let's do this and do this amazing. And where every camp is closed down, no camps are open for this summer, we're gonna say, you know what? We need to come together and we're going to do something awesome. And we want to do something that is incredible, something that kids are going to remember for the rest of their lives. They're going to be going, wow, you remember that one time when it was so difficult and depressing because I was stuck inside, but then when I finally came out, when we were able to finally come together, we did indoor surfing, we did roller coasters, we did water parks. I got to know who Jesus was around a fire pit while the pastor was making the craziest, biggest s'more he possibly could stuff into his face. That's going to be him, right? Do you remember that time where the pastor was also trying to do indoor surfing and almost broke his nose? That's going to be me, right? Totally. But we want to do something that is incredible, that is amazing, that is awesome, that they're going to remember for the rest of their lives. And this is the time to do it. But in order to have this big thing, in order to do this amazing thing, this incredible thing, and to get as many students as we possibly can and as many leaders as we possibly can, we need you. We need you. We need $8,000 donated. And it doesn't have to be one person or anything like that, but we need to have people coming together and saying, hey, you know what? We see the value in this. We love our students. We love our community. We see that right now the students need this, and we want to help you with that. And so if you are that person, if you're that person saying, you know what, I want to help you with that. I want to help get students out of the house. I want to help students know who Jesus is. And I want to help make that memory for the students for the rest of their lives. Then would you please give? Would you donate to this cause? Would you help us with this? You can find the link right down at the bottom of your screen and right down on the post as well. But you can donate through this way. It goes to a 501c3, so it is also tax deductible. You're able to claim it on your taxes. But I want you guys to know that where this money is going and the heart that is behind it. And the heart that is behind it is the students. It is the students. It's getting them out. It's saying, hey, you know what? It's time. We need to come together. And we're going to do this as safe as possible and as great as possible. And we're going to follow all laws in Washington and all laws in Idaho. And it's going to be fantastic. But we want to make sure they have a way of getting out, a way of making a memory that they are going to have for the rest of their lives. And I guarantee you by the end of that trip, they're going to know who Jesus is. They're going to have new relationships and friendships that are going to be so expanded. Like, you're going to be seeing these students, and they're going to be coming together, and they're going to have these new best friends that they're going to have the rest of their lives. This is going to be something that is going to be a life changer. Would you give to being a life changer? Now, you had a couple of questions. What are your questions for me?
Some questions. What's your heart behind it?
My heart is the students. You know it. Yeah.
I think you've answered a lot of them, but let's say I am a parent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And let's start with why Idaho? I mean,
good question.
Why Idaho?
Yeah, why Idaho? So here's the thing. Now we have differences between Idaho and Washington and so forth. Now if you paid any attention to any of the camps and things that are here in Washington, mm-hmm. pretty much all of the camps are really sad. It's so difficult. But all of the camps and all the places have closed down for the whole year because mm-hmm. they didn't have any registration at the start of it, right? And so they've closed down for the whole year. Most camps across the country are pretty much closed. And it's not because it won't be safe in July. It's because they didn't get any early signups at this month, you know, in June and in May and so forth. And a lot of the camps, they could not financially sustain throughout the year without those early signups.
Okay.
And so that's why a lot of them have canceled. But at the same time, why Idaho? Well, a big part of it is because Idaho is opening up way sooner than Washington.
Okay.
And in a different way. So they have different things that we're able to do in Idaho than we would be able to do in Washington. However, we are going to follow all of the rules, restrictions as we can from Washington and Idaho. We're going to make sure that we are following all laws, procedures, everything like that. The other reason why we're doing Idaho is because of this resort. So in this time of COVID, difficulties and so forth, we want to make sure that we are as safe as possible. The reason why this trip is going to cost a little more, why we're having to do it at a resort, is to be extra safe, extra careful. The resort is keeping everything extra clean. We're going to have hand sanitizer stations at every point. We're going to be having groups in their own kind of a distancing thing. So when the groups get set out and they're in one car, they're in that same group for the whole trip. So together as groups, we're going to be together. So that way we're limiting some of that struggle of having too many people coming together, right?
Okay.
So we're gonna have that. The resort is gonna help us with that as well. Also, the resort is just an amazing resort that is totally for us and saying, you know what, we wanna make sure that you guys are gonna have an amazing time, but we're gonna make sure you guys are safe, you guys are provided for, and so forth. They're taking care of that. The other thing is, and this is my own selfish thing, or also my own observation is you know what, we've also found out that chlorine kills COVID. Chlorine kills COVID, right? You're not going to have any kind of a thing with chlorine. And everywhere we are going, there is a water park with lots and lots of chlorine. So over at the hotel, they have an indoor water park. When we do our day over at Silverwood, there is a huge water park that's there and everything that we're going to be going into as well. And so it's going to be an amazing experience. But Idaho is the way that we're able to provide this experience and be able to do it safely, the safest possible. Mm. We're also going to be following different social distancing regimes and protocols. Calls over at Silverwood to make sure that we are as safe as possible there. But Silverwood is working with us in an amazing way, and they're making sure that we are safe and able to do this in the most responsible fashion. So why Idaho? Because they're opened up, but also because they're able to accommodate our group and make sure that we are also staying safe while we're following all the rules and procedures as well.
Okay. Sounds good to me. It almost seems that in priority, safety first.
Safety first.
That's 1A.
Yep.
1B is fun.
Yeah. Safety first, fun. Actually, I'm going to say this. Okay. Actually, we're going to change that around. So A is Jesus. So A is Jesus. Let's go with Jesus.
Camp.
Yeah. So A is Jesus. Two is going to be safety. Three is going to be let's have fun. Let's get out together and let's do this.
And
four is relationships. You know what? Students right now are needing relationships more than ever. Students right now are needing to know that they are loved, that they are cared for. Students need to know that we are there for them. And this is going to be a trip just like that, where they're going to, by the end of it, there's going to be no doubt that we are there for them, that we love them, that we appreciate them, and that Jesus loves them. And they're going to make relationships and friendships that are going to last forever.
Amen.
Yeah.
Sounds good to me.
Fantastic.
I'm ready. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's do this.
Are you ready?
Let's hope. So here's what we need from you, though. Here's what we need from you. And now, if you have any questions, if you have any concerns about anything, then please never hesitate to call me. I will answer my phone. I would love to speak to you. I'd love to speak to any of the parents and students and anybody who has any questions, concerns, or anything like that. But here's what I need from you. In order to make this camp happen, in order to make this go on, in order for us to be able to come together and to do this in the best way possible for all of the students, we need $8,000.
That's it?
$8,000. We need $8,000. Yeah, well, and think about it too. It's not just like one person. We're not asking one person to do that. We're saying, hey, look, we've got multiple churches that are going to come together and do this. And the reason why we have multiple churches coming together to do this is because we love all of our students from all of our communities. And we love also Kingdom Perspective and saying, you know what? We should be together. Like, let's do this together. Let's fight together. Let's be with this together. Let's have fun with our students together.
Let's do it.
Let's build these relationships together. So, but we need $8,000 combined. So $8,000, and that would take the price for all of the students down a very, very affordable level. And it also makes it so that way, we can invite more students. We can invite more students. At $8,000, we're able to have around 50 students, right? So at $8,000 donated, that's 50.
50.
Yep. If we were only to get 6,000 students, then we would only be able to offer this to about 30 to 35 students around there because of the rooms, the hotels, and stuff like that. Above 8,000, all of a sudden, we're able to offer this to even more students. And so we're wanting to make sure that we get as many students as we possibly can. We're wanting to make sure that we have leaders that are invested in these, group leaders that are saying, hey, I love these students. I am there for you. And we're wanting to make sure that this is the best experience possible for all of these kids. Would you be a part of that? Would you help us with that? Would you help fundraise? Would you help us to do that? You can donate at the website that is listed below and on this screen, and you can donate over on faithfellowshipchurch.net. There is another tab that is going to be up there that just says for student camp. And so we just pray that you would do that, that you would donate for this, and that you see the value. And if anybody has any questions again, and you want to know the heart behind this, you want to know why we're doing this with students or what the students can expect, please always give us a call. Thank you.
Thank you.